Phaco in extremely hard brown cataract is always challenging. The challenges are mainly because of the higher amount of energy which is required to emulsify the nucleus. Hence, one has to pay attention in each step of the surgery, right from the creation of the wound, which should not be very tight enough, otherwise there are more chances of wound burn. The endothelium must be taken care of because of the excessive use of energy and flying nucleus fragment can cause damage to the endothelium. So copious amount of viscoelastics, good quality viscodispersive OVD has to be used, and as far as possible the Phaco has to be done inside the bag. Also, one has to take care that these patients are more prone to have zonular dehiscence or posterior capsule rupture. So one has to take proper precautions and have to use the energy judiciously during the procedure. One should aim for little bigger capsular axis, and multiple point hydrodissection should be attempted. One should ensure that the nucleus is rotating freely. I'll be doing direct chop here. One should use sharp bigger chopper, and the Phaco needle should be more exposed. It can be done by retracting the sleeve little more. After holding the nucleus with the Phaco needle, I am using the chopper to divide, to separate the nucleus in two pieces. Because of the density and increased anteroposterior thickness of the nucleus, it is not possible to separate the nucleus in two pieces at one go. So multiple maneuver has to be done, and after rotating the nucleus, the same thing has to be repeated from the other side. A lot of patience is required to separate the nucleus till the posterior plate. Once the hard nucleus is divided into two pieces, more than half of the work is done. It is now necessary to divide each half of the nucleus into multiple pieces before it is emulsified. It is important that everything is done in the capsular bag, and copious amount of viscoelastic has to be used in between so that the endothelium is protected and there is less chance of injury to the endothelium. Once each half is divided into multiple pieces, each piece can be now emulsified. At this point of time, chopper can be used to just push the pieces behind and not allowing it to come near to the endothelium so that it doesn't hurt the endothelium. Centurion machine with active fluidics adds many advantages in managing such type of cataract because of proper and a more efficient utilization of the energy, at the same time giving a very stable anterior chamber without any fluctuation. In such cataract, which generally require more energy, but with the use of a balanced tip and more efficient energy utilization, there is less chances of collateral injury, and at the same time, since there is less fluctuation of the anterior chamber, there are less chances of posterior capsule rupture and subsequent problems related to it. One has to be more cautious while removing the last piece of the nuclear fragment, but with this machine, with the active fluidics, there are less chances of surge, so the complications of posterior capsule rupture at this point of time is almost nil. You can see the amount of energy used, which is less than 34 CD even with this hardness of the cataract, and there is no wound burn, and this is the final appearance of the case. You can see the cornea is very clear.